So, going deeper into scoring territory, where it's today it's again Star Weaver against Raven. I will be playing again Scorn for once. Scenario skill box, 10-minute rounds, steamroller. Hey. I am on the roll-off, so I'll be heading out first.
I brought a maximum unit of Praetorian Swordsmen with UA. I brought two Titan Gladiators, a Mordekaiser, an Agonizer, a minimum unit of Beast Handlers, Smoke, Fog, Bellows, Crew, Gobbers, something like that. And that was that.
It off with the same Jarl Skuld list again, meaning a full unit of Nis Hunters, Janissa Stonetide, Jarl Skuld, Mauler, Unit of Krill with all the bells and whistles, and the Falcorder. Oh, I'm sorry, and there's supposed to be an Impaler somewhere.
Zeer we good.
Impaler.
Gained 6 fury, swordsman ran up, everything the rest ran up, I casted leash on Mordekaiser, I then dumped 4 fury in the agonizer, leaving me with no fury, swarm grabbers, walked up, popped smoke, and that's it. Yeah, and I have some riling going on, I have total 6.
I activated Jarl first, put Tactical Supremacy on the Krills, Quicken on the Archers, moved up, shot down two of the Swordsmen, Janissa moved up, created the wall, Nis moved up. As I'm not used to playing on the clock, I move everything a lot faster than I'm used to, and because of that I made a stupid beginner mistake, I placed my unit leader here. Those four pass the test, but they can't do anything this turn. They will have to move back at the start of the next turn if they're still out of command range, which they most likely will be. Then they shot at the swordsman, killed a few. They don't have to take leadership test because of Makeda.
Yes.
Krill ran up, Mauler ran up, and Impaler ran up. He gave him Pathfinder, just in case. Didn't really need it. And that's about it.
So, seeing an opportunity to kill his caster, my opponent went like, eh? I had the same opinion at that point, by the way. Anyway, I started off with the swordsman. They made a vengeance move, charged around. I killed actually Lanissa, which is actually in the hindsight the best idea I did ever, because otherwise I wouldn't have made the reach and range. Mm-hmm. So anyway, lucky roll, she died and kept another one. Then, having a bit more room, I moved up Makeda, casted Engine of Destruction and Road to War. She charged on this, didn't do anything. Because, yeah, she didn't make it, but I had to have the range on the boost. So her activation ended. Then Mordekaiser got dragged up 3 inches towards her, so I did. Gladiator caused a rush on Mordek, ran, Gnawing Pain on the Agonizer, Beasthanders, and Rage. Fork forgot to pop smoke, but hey, who cares? I then activated Mordekaiser, charging a troll who's standing here. Hitting him, not making a stop save, thank god, and then he moved up 2 inches. At first sight, I wasn't really in range of him, but just a few millimeters. However, I was looking and I didn't saw that I didn't was in base-to-base contact with his mauler. So hey, I could have moved a little bit further, so I did. So that's why we placed the base. And then at that point, I did have range, and he didn't have his 19 defense hardcover. At that point, it was a struggle of will. I rolled, I hit, did boosted on the damage, rolled 11 damage. Boosted again, they didn't boost on damage. I boosted on the hit, did not boost not on the damage, did 8. He transferred to an impaler, I bought the last attack. Future Sight, didn't even use Future Sight, double 5s or something, and then I boosted the damage, and I did 5. 23 damage, and I kill him outright. So, hindsight goes to my opponent.
First of all, I blame Ralph for not getting his score properly. I say that when I saw what was happening, I was thinking, thank God I have the freaking wall. Yeah. The wall is just too short to be safe on both sides. I guess next time I put the wall a bit more towards that side, because on this side you're protected by the forest, but it is one hell of an attack factor. It's insane.
Thank you.
Yes.
I try my best. So yeah, this is actually how the Mordekaiser bullet works. And that's why they call it the Mordekaiser bullet. I always... by the way, it's the first...
Oh, tough roll.
Tough roll, indeed. Yes.
Ah!
Not tough. Anyway, he forgot it anyway, so... So, he didn't make a stop save, so he actually really, really died for the people who are going to like, oh, he didn't make a stop save, he died. Anyway, this was Mordekaiser Bullet. I actually never have played Scorn at least Makeda before, so hey, that's how, I won't say that easy to pull off, but when you're looking for it, there is really an opening really fast, and I didn't actually, I mean, it's like a Card of Beast 09, tactics.
And especially in Killbox, and you have to be close. Jarl would probably have been close anyway, but...
I would have been able to trample 50... Okay, it's medium, but anything else, in War Machine, there's not much medium going around. So I just can trample over... Hey,
I blocked your trample with the 10 models, getting a 10-inch path you can't trample over.
Do you have...
Just make it 15.
Yes, do you have a Wittigard Death Star? I don't care. Oh, by the way, I forgot to... That was the whole bleh of it, so I had to sometimes boost my attacks, otherwise I would have had more attacks without the boosting, 2 more.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe you can make 2 more tough saves.
One.
Okay. He was virtually very dead, check. So, yeah, all in all, I mean, oh my god. The sheer power of this is amazing.